There he is. Look at this guy. All tall and
that's a heck of an intro.
Good looking. Have a seat, my friend. We're on the air here. Put those headphones on. Ryan Hurd is here. Let me play some of this new song, by the way. Here's Ryan Hurd to a T. Tonight, girl, I'll take my time. You.
Hey,
how you feeling?
I feel good.
How was the new year?
It was really nice.
Yeah, what'd you guys do?
Maren played in New Orleans for Dick Clark, and then we actually got home in time for midnight, so we were just kind of like sat at the house and had some champagne and then went to bed.
Was that performance for New Year's Eve not recorded?
They actually recorded a performance the day before because they thought it was going to rain, but then ended up doing it live.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Because I have a lot of friends that played, and they went like a month earlier.
Yeah, all the L.A. stuff, I think, was
that's what it was, yeah.
So I think New York and L.A. were live, which was really cool. It was an awesome event. It's always cool to see, like, her do, like, cool stuff and also, like, see behind the scenes how it all comes together. It was a really fun New Year's.
What's the goal for you this year? Big Ryan Hurd New Year's resolution.
You know what? I didn't make one, but I'm really happy right now, and I'm excited to make more music and get to put more songs out. So I don't know. I think I learned a lot last year about myself, and I got married, and so this year I'm kind of just enjoying all those things. And I don't have any like big thing that I want. I mean, we have hopes that like maybe we'll sell some more tickets for our shows and get to put a whole album out. But like,
for
as
what
far
shows
as
though, Ryan Hurd, everything you have is sold out. I was looking online. It's like Hollywood, sold out. The Bowery Ballroom, sold out. New York, Chicago, sold out. Exit in Nashville, sold out.
Yeah, I want to play more of those.
But I mean, they're not even for sale right now. They're in for sale. Oh, anyway, now look at you. Ryan Hurd is here. I'm going to play this song first before we get to talking a little more. This is To a T. Tell me about this song.
Well, I wrote it with Laura Veltz, who wrote Rich for Maren, and I Could Use a Love Song, and she wrote We Do Us, which you played before anybody else did. And she's just a really close friend that we kind of have come up writing songs with. And I have tons of songs that I've recorded for my record company. And when I played them this one, they kind of stopped everything else and said, this is the one we have to run with. So I don't know. It's just a song that I think is like, it's a sentiment that everybody feels, but is kind of said in a really fresh way. And it was really fun to write like all the wordplay in the back of the chorus. And when we put it out, it's definitely been the song that has reacted the most with listeners and fans, and it's been a really exciting ride already.
To a T. Here we go. I'm going to play this. Wait, do you think of what, maybe in this instance, like Maren or before you did, like whatever, do you think of people when you write songs and write specifically about people?
There's a joke in Nashville with songwriters. They say that if you're writing a song with Ryan, you're writing a song about Maren. And so that has been going on, I guess, for 3 years now. And like, it's kind of nice to have a muse that everybody can point to. And nobody has to guess what's being written about. But it was also really nice to put out a song that's not super personal, because we put out like Love in a Bar, and that was like an autobiographical song. We put out Diamonds, and that was Diamonds Are Twine, and that was like our wedding song. And now it's just nice to put out just a straight up love song that's not super specific to anything. But I really do love like that it's obviously about her, and she's singing on it, which is cool. It's just, she knows she can sing on whatever she wants to.
Oh, and Maren sings on this, that's her in the back?
Yeah, she's just doing the harmonies, and she liked this song before anybody else did, and told me I was really stupid for not putting it out. But she just kept saying, you need to put out To a T, you need to put out To a T, and then I was gonna put out something different, and then ended up that this was the right choice. And I have a really good A&R team.
Hey, so you had another number one since we saw you last. Ryan Hurd wrote this song, too. Sunrise, somebody wrote this?
Yep. I picture, actually, when I'm in the car, if this comes on, this is weird, but I picture you, like, painting a house somewhere.
What do you
it's
mean?
It's weird. Well, because I know he wrote it, and when he's talking about getting out the paint and painting the lake house or whatever, I like him picturing him painting. It's weird.
You picture Ryan painting, not Luke.
Yeah, Ryan.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah. I don't know who the
girl. You picture me doing all the work.
Yes.
I remember when Luke, because I was on American Idol last year and I'm back on this year, but I remember when, I think Luke played this on the Idol finale, and it was the first time he had played it, and I was like, I was so happy for you.
Yeah.
I'm happy for Luke, but Luke's rich and Luke's awesome. He's, you know, he's done. Luke's here. But I was happy for you because I was like, hey, Ryan's song. Like, he's going to pay the bills for a while now. It's good.
That dude is exactly what you see with him is exactly what you get. He is everything you see on television. He is that nice in person, and he's a genuine dude. And he went out of his way to like mention my name and the other songwriters' names. And usually, I mean, there's 60 songs on the chart right now, and a lot of times nobody will ever know who wrote those songs. But it's really cool to have somebody like just really go out of their way to make sure that like the songwriters got mentioned. Like there's at his show, he had a billboard kind of in the back, like all over the bar and all over his backstage and like in the crowd saying like, thank you, Ryan Hurd, Chase McGill, Zach Crowell for writing, like with the album art and stuff like that. And he's just a really special guy. And I think like our genre is really lucky to have him.
Yeah, I like your necklace, your chain there.
Thanks, man.
You know what? You were talking about a muse earlier. You've been my muse a bit.
For jewelry.
That's a high compliment.
Well, because how long ago, Amy, was I talking about I'd like to wear a necklace or a chain like Ryan Hurd?
Like middle of last year.
Right. I think it looks like you have one.
I do. I still, this is in your honor.
That's awesome.
I still wear it.
That's a good one too.
Look at this.
All right, we're going to get into it now.
But you're the inspiration. You're
that's
my
cool.
inspiration.
That's a huge compliment.
Wow, you got more. You have
no,
hidden
this
necklaces.
One, I wear this one every day under my shirt.
Yeah?
It's this little like...
crystal?
It's a crystal that I got from this lady who made Marin's engagement ring. Actually, my wedding ring too. But I wear this one every day. And then I switch out the one on the outside of the shirt. So that's my that's my secret.
But when I first started wearing this chain, Amy gave me such crap.
I did.
Oh,
she was it was awkward because Bobby's not a necklace guy. And then all of a sudden,
I'm not a
like,
jewelry guy.
You start it like that though. You start wearing it on the inside, and you get like, kind of used to it. And then you get a little more adventurous, and then you
and
start
then you
wearing bracelets.
And,
yeah, I need to work on that Audi. Can you like find me a good Audi one to wear?
Totally. No, we can totally do this. We'll text about it.
Ryan's cool.
Because what's
be
the
cool.
on your the one you're wearing on the outside today? It's like turquoise beads, but what's the thing?
It's like a little Buddha hand. It's okay. Cool. I don't know. It's I don't know. I have like the same hand with like a I honestly don't even know what
it
is.
It just
is,
looks cool.
To be
hey
honest.
Man,
it does look
whatever
cool.
works.
It just looks
it's fine.
I just enjoy how it looks. So,
you good? Otherwise, like everything good? You about to crank into this year? You
yeah.
got a plan?
I think. I'm really happy right now. I don't really know what else to... There's not a lot of stuff in my life that I would get rid of at the moment, so that's a good way to start the new year.
Yeah, that's a good way. You got to put out this new song.
But just in case you
want to change your mind. It's called Michigan for the Winter?
Yeah.
You're from Michigan.
Yeah.
Ryan's a big hockey guy. I grew up in Arkansas. I don't know anything about hockey. So Ryan and I would be at hockey games. We go to like the Preds game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'd be like, dude, walk me through this.
I grew up around it. I wish I played because you have to start when you're like 7 or 8 years old. So I grew up playing baseball and stuff that like my dad grew up playing. But this song, I wrote this song took like 3 or 4 months to write. I wrote it with like my friend Aaron, who's from Michigan too. And we started it and then took like 3 or 4 times getting back to write it. And I ended up finishing it like in the shower one day. I was just like taking a shower and I was like, I got it. So I don't know. This is one that I feel like I should have put out a long time ago just because this is kind of like the most me song I've ever really put out. It's this like kind of the best example of what I do as a songwriter. So I'm really just thankful that I got to put it out.
I was looking at your Twitter. Apparently, there's a scientist named Ryan Hurd.
Oh, my gosh.
Because I'm so jealous that you have your name as a handle. Because some dude named Bobby Bones, he doesn't even use it. It blocks people. It's Bobby Bones. And I have Mr. Bobby Bones. And you have Ryan Hurd. But this guy's actually kind of famous.
So, all right. When I started using Twitter, I was at Hurd Jams with a Z. And
wow. Good thing you got away from that. Holy cow.
My friends still call me that.
Hurd Jams?
Hurd Jams.
Yeah.
And because I was just joking around, I was just a writer and didn't have a public anything. And so, but this guy, he's a dream scientist, and his name is Ryan Hurd. And he got so sick of people like reaching out to him thinking that he was me.
Yeah.
That like when I ended up getting in touch with him, being like, "Hey man, what would it take?" He was like, "Thank you so much." So I had to.
Did you pay him?
Oh, yeah.
They tried to buy Bobby Bones for my birthday, and the guy wouldn't sell it.
Yeah, he was like 18. He wasn't giving it up. And I'm like, he's 18. You're a kid. He was. This was like 10 years ago.
He should give it up for like $20 if he's 18.
Yeah.
It was.
Did you see what the scientist changed his handle to?
No.
Science Jams with a J. Yeah. With a Z. Yeah.
Dreams.
Yeah.
No, he's actually a very interesting dude. It's wild what he does. He's actually the top of his field. So.
Yeah. So now you like are friends with him or?
We're friendly.
Do you ever text him?
No.
Do you ask him about your dreams?
No, but he was like very thankful to get out of at Ryan Hurd. So.
Well, Ryan Hurd is here with us. Man, look at you. This is your year, man.
Thank you. It's kind of fun too because you've played so many of my songs and now like we're getting to run with To a T and that was when you really got behind. So finally, one that you've supported is going to get to the radio across the country.
To me, it's not even about that. To me, it's not about what gets played. I just like find good songs and play them.
Well, that's why people love your show. And I think it's, I don't know, I've always been really thankful for the support you've thrown my way. And even before I had anything going and like to finally have one that's like, all right, everything's behind this one. And, you know, it makes me thankful for what you've done and also like thankful that we get to run with this song for the year.
Ryan Hurd is here to a T. By the way, you talk about playing ball. You're a pretty big dude, right? Are you big your whole life?
I've always been like 6'3" since like freshman year of high school. So.
So in ninth grade, you're 6'3".
Yeah.
Were you just killing chicks?
What?
At 6'3" in ninth grade, like getting all of them.
Ew.
Like just killing it.
I went to a really small high school, that was the kind of high school where like you had to play every sport or else like they wouldn't be able to have a team. So. I spent most of my time doing that.
That was not the question, though. Like, you're 6'3" and 9th
grade.
Well,
that makes you even more appealing, right? Because you're, like, the star athlete. Or were you good, or were you not good?
Oh, we were good.
No, you, not your team.
When did the beard come in? Like, 9th grade?
I wasn't allowed.
The shadow,
I had
when did you wear necklaces? 9th grade? The whole thing happened in, like, 9th grade. Yeah,
30.
You start playing guitar.
I liked guitar. I played in when I was a kid. I didn't, get serious about music till like, right after college, though. But... I grew up playing baseball, and that was the sport that I was best at. So
we're just giving you a hard time because we're jealous of all your looks and talent and height and necklaces. And
every time I leave this studio, I feel great.
You should because you come in and we're just jealous.
Hey, seriously though, you're doing the necklace thing right. Tuck it in for a little bit, get used to it, and then get a little more adventurous. That's the way that I did it.
The only time I will adventure out on wearing an outward necklace is if you find one and you go, Bobby, this would be for you. Because otherwise, I don't think I can pull it off. I don't have the confidence yet, so I'm going to wait for you to go.
No,
the one for you.
Have the Ryan Hurd blessing.
I got you.
Yeah.
I got you. So, see, but you have tattoos. Mm-hmm. I've been really slow into the tattoo.
You don't have any?
No, I have two.
Oh, okay.
But they're tiny. And
like what? Did,
they're
what?
Like right here on my hands. So like you can see them, but I've always been like jealous of dudes who can have like a bunch of tattoos because that means they don't have to.
Bobby. He's jealous of you.
Because, you know what happens.
Because when you have a bunch of tattoos, you don't have to, like, all you have to wear is a t-shirt, and then, like, you already have, you're basically dressed for the day.
It's your accessories.
Yeah.
Well, my face tattoo was quite the gamble.
I was telling, Marin and I need to get the Post Malone Always Tired tattoos.
Under your eyes? Yeah.
Because it feels like we're always exhausted, but.
Well, my friend, I'm very happy to see you.
You too.
I'm glad to see that you're getting, like, good support now. Like, your team's going. Not just your team, but like the team, the label team, the record team's going, we got one here.
Man, they've been super supportive, and I'm really pumped to get to do everything I get to do with Sony Music.
At Ryan Hurd, RyanHurd. If you happen to follow his old handle, Hurd Jams, you need to change and go over to the new one. All right, good to see you, bud.
See you later.
This is a Bobby Bones Show.